Yeah, so today we are going to see about career in RPA as a business service. So we have seen the transformations of an RPA and the digital transformations been happening from last 3-4 years. RPA is the one of the major technology where the manual task or the mundane task has been automated, and it's been a very fantastic journey with the RPA. So I don't want to repeat what of all what is RPA and how the RPA has been in the industry. Most of you know. The people who are new to this RPA, the RPA is robotic process automation. So it is the technology where we are going to automate the repetitive manual tasks or the repetitive mundane tasks which are being done human, which have been done by the humans. And the simple word I can tell. RPA, most of you, if you are first time you are listening, robotics process automation, it is not any humanoid robot or something like that. It is a technology where we do the automation for our current running jobs or current running processes or current running automation techniques, what we talk. Okay, so in the RPA journey also, we have different roles. For example, developer, senior developer, solution architect, business analyst, manager, senior manager, likewise. So why we are here to learn about our business analyst mostly? Business analyst is the one of the key role which will be playing a major reference or major use in the RPA project. It's been transformed the industry, like every project or every process we do see business analyst is available. So business analyst is playing a major role from the start of the RPA project to the delivery of the RPA project. So that is why business analyst is one of the major and key role according to the RPA processes and the projects, or even the similar role which he leads to the process. So first of all, who is an RPA business analyst? So what he is going to do in the RPA projects? So RPA business analyst is one of the person or one of the candidate where he will be interacting with the multiple teams, for example, the business team, for example, the development team, for example, the customers, for example, the testing team, or the all the different. He is the bridge between the all the teams, or he is the bridge between the customers, business, and the development team, and he will be acting as an a bridge for all the, and he will be analyzing the complete processes, or he will be analyzing the complete system, or he will be able to analyze the processes which are going to automate. So that is why PA is the person which plays a key role from starting from initial process assessment to the delivery of the project. PA will be involved in each and every stage. And we will talk more on the roles or responsibilities or what PA will play in the different stages. We will discuss further. Okay. As I said, roles. So it is not, if you see the slide and all, it is not limited to PA will not, mostly the myth we have a common myth where people are thinking that PA is the person who collect the requirements and simply he documents it and he send it across the business teams or the development teams. No, it is a myth you people are having in the industry, or maybe the person who are been not in the address to the business analyst, so they are thinking like that. It is not the case. As I said, he will be involving each and every stage of an RPA process from initial phase to the end phase. Okay, from the initial phase to the end phase, BA will be there, and BA will be playing his roles and responsibilities as per the process, as per the project, and as per the delivery. So he will be collecting the data from the customers. He will be delivering it to the development team. He will be taking care of the inputs collection, output collections. He will be part of the testing team. He will be involving in UATs, and he will be reporting to the stakeholders. And he will be, in some of the cases, he will be handling the scrum meeting, team meetings, weekly meetings, daily meetings, whatever we call, he will be handling that. The main major and responsibilities, so we do see and we do address as a business analyst. And if you see, there are multiple tools in the industry. Business analyst is not limited to any particular tool. For example, it is we have, if you can see the top tools, we have UiPath, Blue Prism, Automation Anywhere, and we have Power Automate, other tools as well. Why I mentioned the tools, you know, here, business analyst is not the candidate where he will work for a particular, and he is not specifically to a single tool. He should be able to learn, he should be able to talk, he should be able to analyze, or he should be able to do the process or the analyze the process or estimate the process apart from the tool, or it is not fixed for any tool. He should be flexible. The business analyst should be flexible to work, or flexible to capture, or flexible to analyze, or flexible to do the requirements or anything. So that is why we have multiple tools in the industry. So business analyst will be working as per the project or as per the process. It depends. Initially, he may be working on UiPath process. Later, he may be transformed to other tools as well. And here, if you have seen, so mostly in the RPA projects, we see COE. What is COE? COE is a Center of Excellence team. We call Center of Excellence team. In the RPA projects, we do see COE teams in the companies, where there will be a different set of teams who will be handling the COE to deliver the projects or to deliver the customer's requirement efficiently. The most that the resources, along with the developers, business analyst, managers, and the testing team or a support team, will be doing the COE part. Okay, so if you see, there will be a COE leader, maybe a manager, maybe a senior delivery manager, maybe a director, according to the project. Okay, controller, designer, developer, administrator, IT, infrastructure lead. So it may be varies. So it is just an image, but it definitely varies. So if you need to assume here, in this COE team, there will be a business analyst, there will be a testing team, there will be a developer, there will be a solution architect, and there will be manager as well. The COE team is the core team where the complete RPA projects or RPA delivery team will be sit, and they will be monitoring the processor, because in one project, there will be 10 processes also. In one company, there will be 10 projects as well. In 10 projects, there are 100 processes are being there. 100 processes means there will be like around 50 plus developers, 20 solution architects, 10 managers, likewise. But the COE team is the common team, delivery team, we can call, and they will be addressing, or they will be doing the complete structure or the accumulations for the resources or the deployments, whatever the customer requirement as per they will work. So that is simply about a COE. And if you can see, who should become an RPA business analyst. So why we all are here? So we are learning about RPA business analyst. So most of you may not be from an RPA background, or most of you may not be from a business analyst background, but you are here to learn something about RPA. And then definitely you people will have a question that, do I fit into this business analyst role? Do I stand a good RPA business analyst? How? So that is why I am going to tell. So who can become the candidate who having a good understanding skills, who having a lot of patience, who is having a curiosity to learn the new concepts or new technologies or the new businesses, who can understand the the processes which are going to be automated given by the business, who having a good communicational skills, who is having a good analytical skills, who is able to do the requirements with the different language, and who can think always, who can think always in two or three different ways. For example, there is a process came and the business team, the customers is telling, hey, to Nikhilesh, this is the process. Do you automate? Then business analyst is the candidate need to sit and understand the process, analyze the process, and he should be able to judge the business, and he should to understand the functionality of the business. For example, banking, healthcare, finance, there will be different functionalities and different domains. You don't need to have the different domain knowledge, but at least you are need to able to understand, or you should able to learn the new thing. Because see, for example, I am not in proficient of every domain available in the industry, but I am able to understand the new domain. For example, healthcare, I don't have enough knowledge, but I am going to do a requirement for a healthcare project. So, but you, before going to the healthcare project, you just analyze what is the healthcare terms, what are the major terms in the healthcare, what are the processes may be available in healthcare. You just need to do your research. That is why I said one word, business analyst should have their own passion, own patience to do the things which you need to do the proper elaborations. Okay, that is why we are calling, he should be always available to the customers, he should be always available to the development team, he should be always available to the solution team, testing team, managers team, like that. He will be inclined with each and every candidate, he will be inclined with each and every item in the process. He should be having an approach of zoom in and zoom out session, zoom in and zoom out approach. So he should be able to understand, and he should be able to think, he should able to flexible, and business analyst should be flexible, always need to be flexible environment. I hope you can estimate now that whether you fit into this technology or the business analyst role. Again, I'm one more thing I can add into here. If I said lot of things, who can become RPA business analyst? Don't you think you cannot you cannot become an RPA business analyst? Don't you think? Don't you have this kind of skills? Don't you have this approach? Yes, everybody is having this own approach. Just you need to think, and you just need to practice, and you just need to learn the skill. That's it. And one more advantage of the added advantage, that if you have any programming knowledge priorly, if you have any technical knowledge priorly, even in a testing background, even in a SAP background, even a finance functional background, definitely it will be an added advantage to your role. Definitely it will be an added advantage to your role. Okay. So that is something about the business analyst. And career path. So how this career path for a business analyst been there in the industry? So nowadays, every process or every RPA project is having this business analyst role, and it's been in the industry from 3-4 years, but the business analyst been roles been started. Even there are lots of opportunities available in the market, especially into RPA. If you can see, if you have a the roles like junior BS, BA, senior BA, lead BA, or the program manager, delivery manager, associate manager, like this, it will be depending on your role, on experience and your knowledge, as vice versa. So, and it may be varies from the company to company. It may be varies from the customer to customer accordingly. Maybe in a MNC company, they may give you a senior BA, junior BA, but in a small organization, they may give you a senior BA. So it depends on the customer to company to company, experience to experience, and all. So as I said, career path of a business analyst will be definitely a good option, or definitely if you are fit into the skill set which I explained you earlier, you can be land into a good job. Market is having good opportunities for the business analyst as well. So this is something about the business analyst. So this is something about the business analyst. And let me go to the next slide. So before going to the next slide, so I would like to see one or two messages that if any. Okay. So questions, I mean, we will take it later. So not a problem. Okay, so next we have SDLC in RPA. So first of all, what is SDLC? We all know SDLC is the software development life cycle. Okay, every project will have its own SDLC. Every project will have its own methodologies to deliver the projects. Okay, so why it is required in RPA and what are the different phases available in the SDLC of an RPA, we will see. SDLC, I no need to repeat it again, but why it is required and why we are concentrating on it. Okay, so if we have the SDLC, it will describe about the life cycle of any business processes or any business projects will be involved. And it is going to discuss or it is going to evolve in the different stages of the people or the different stages of a team where the RPA or the other teams are being evolved and how these teams are being distributed or how these teams are being working. So like that, who is responsible for each stage or who is going to deliver this, who is going to work on this, it will work. Okay. And what is the uses of the SDLC or why we need to use the SDLC techniques? Or if I'm telling SDLC means, it may be a methodology where you work or where you use the agile methodology, waterfall methodology, whatever we call. Okay. So why we need to use and what are the uses of the SDLC basically? So every process should be identified, should be able to analyze the process, design the process, develop, test and deliver. This is the technique. And to ensure the customer expectations or to ensure the customer requirement, to ensure to deliver the customer identification or the customer delivery, we should follow the process or we should follow the techniques. For example, there are 10 RPA processes being identified and there are development already started. And some of the either 5 or 6 processes are being in the testing part or 5 other processes are being in the documentation part. Every process will not be in the same stage or the same phase. So if we follow the SDLC, if we follow the methodology according to the project or the customer, we can estimate the time, we can estimate the cost, and we can ensure to reach the deliverables as expected. And we can think or we can estimate like, yeah, for example, 5 developers are being working in this process. Where is this process? Is this in the testing? Is this in development? Is this in testing stage or UAT stage, whatever we call. So different stages and different things we will do, it will be addressed and it will be focused. So that is why SDLC is very, very important to learn. And it should be the focused on the delivery part. And if you see, these are the major and important phases of RPA high level. And if you see discovery phase, documentation phase, development phase, testing, UAT, deployment, handover, change request, and maintenance. These are the some of the highlights or some of the stages where the SDLC we will follow and where we will do the things. And as I said initially, in each and every stage or each and every phase, RPA business analyst will play a major role in each and every field, and what he plays and how he will work, let's discuss more. In the discovery phase, we usually be discovery phase. We call it as a discovery phase. We call it as a requirement gathering phase. We can call initially as an initial process assessment. We can call pre-discovery, post-discovery. There are lots of stages been in the discovery phase itself. Okay. In the discovery phase, first of all, what is requirement gathering phase? You are a business analyst. You are from RPA team, and you got a customer called Nokia. Okay. Nokia is having lots of manual processes where the manual team means the agents or the customers or the IT guys where they are working for a daily monitoring process, or there been any working for any ticketing process, or they are working for any ticket resolving process or anything from their business. Nokia is having these businesses, okay? And they approached our management, who are senior management or vice presidents or whatever may be. This senior management will take the business from the Nokia, and they will sign with the the company, for example, any company, and they will start building the use cases. Before going to build any use cases, we need to sit with the business team with the requirement gathering phase, that is called a discovery phase. Here, the business analyst will identify the use cases, prioritize the use cases, analyze the use cases, see the business benefits of the use cases, and pick the right process for the automation, whether it is a good candidate for RPA, whether it is a not good candidate for RPA, and whether it can be suitable for automation or not, he will be identified. For doing all these steps, business analysts will have their own process or own techniques or documentation, vice versa. But I will not elaborate how he will do or what he will do, what are the techniques he is going to apply, because for the requirement gathering or the discovery phase or the IPA, we have another session tomorrow and other speakers is going to explain in detail. But for the high level, as I said, he will be involving in the requirement gatherings. He will sit with the business teams, and he will ask n number of questions to the business team according to the process. He will collect the requirements and he will analyze the requirement, and he will document the draft version of the documentation he will do, and he will see the whether it is a right candidate for automation or whether it is not a right candidate for automation. He will see, and he is the complete responsible person for this discovery phase. And guys, trust me, discovery phase or the requirement gathering phase is one of the important phase or one of the important stage in the RPA. If we take a wrong process, if we take any wrong process for automation, it will lead to the business, or it will lead to the customer engagement failure, or it will lead to the business processes failure. So that is why discovery phase plays a major, major role. So business analyst should be flexible to enough to understand the requirement, analyze the requirement, approach the Zoom and Zoomout sessions, and ask a number of questions to the customers and all. So that is what about discovery phase. So we have different names for this. So we will call as a requirement gathering, we will call as initial process assessment, and we will call is an pre-discovery, post-discovery, like this. Next, we have documentation. Okay, so in the documentation, after the discovery phase, in the initial part of discovery phase, initial part of discovery phase, once the requirement has been identified, once we finalize the processes, this is a good automation, whether it is a good candidate for RPA. And he started collecting the requirements from the business teams. And he will start doing the draft version of the documentations like Azure process map and the process design document or process definition document. So first, what is PDD and what is STD? PDD is the document where business analyst will prepare. Business analyst is the owner for the PDD document. He will be addressing each and every step of the requirement which been identified in the business discovery phase. And he will be explaining each and every step. For example, there is a process with the 20 steps. He will explain each and every step. First step, log into the system. Second step, enter username and password. Third step, go to this web page. Fourth step, and put a query. Fifth step, capture the query results in Excel. Seventh step, modify the Excel with headings. Eighth step, send an email to the customer with the attachment and the drafted. Along with, I mean, this is a simple example I have given. And where a PDD document is the one of the important document, and even SDD also very, very important. PDD document will play a major role, and I can tell it is the heart of any robotic process automation which been identified in the earlier stage. PDD will have screenshots, business exceptions, scenarios, and the process maps like to be process map, as is process map, to be process map, lot more. And this PDD will be creating by business analyst only. When he will create, he will be creating draft version when he is in requirement gathering phase. Once the requirement has been identified successfully, he will be taking care of the complete PDD, and he will take care of the help of solution architect as well. And he will prepare the PDD, and he will take the sign off from the business. What is the sign off? Sign off is the process. Once the document has been identified, we will share with the business team, and we will take them. We will ask them whether we understood the process correct, or whether this is the process we have been identified, and whether it is correct or not. We will take the sign off from the business. Next, what is solution design document? Solution design document is the another important document. Who will prepare this document? Solution architect or a solution architect, majorly solution architect will prepare this document. So this is the document where solution architect will prepare, and in this document there will be a solution designed. I mean, the solution architect will design a solution for this process where been RPA been identified, and it will have the business exception. It will have a complete robot architecture, and it will be given to the development team and to understand the solution, and the solution architect will propose the solution for this process. So who is the owner of this document? Solution architect. Who will prepare this document? Solution architect. And do this solution design document also need to be signed off? Yes, it need to be signed off with the business team. So business analyst and the solution design PDD document and SDD document will play a major role in the RPA processes. That is why these two documents should be always signed off from the business teams. Okay. Again, there is a separate session for this documentation as well. And people will explain about how to create the solution. What are the templates available? What are the industry standard? How to create and how to merge in this? They will explain. Apart from this document, there are any other documents available? Yes, there are the documents available like test cases document, test scenario document, handover document, deployment document, lot more. So we will discuss that more in the next sessions. I think documentation, who will prepare and who are the owner of this PDD document, SDD document. I hope you are clear. That's from the documentation. So as I said, detail under PDD document is the process design document where we will understand the requirement. It will be preparing by the customer. A business analyst, and he will be explaining each and every process of the automation with the Azure map and Azure techniques, and in the to be map will be in the prepared by the business analyst. and solution design document, as you said, it will be preparing the solution, and it will have the tools or approve, it will have the tools and the solutions we prepared, and technical architects will be, technical architect means solution architect will take care of this. So that is what about the solution design document. And the next stage, we have development. So what is development and what we are going to do here? Okay. So development is the stage where we will design our robots, where we will develop our robots, where we will do the development for the process. So who is the responsible for the development? The developers, the architect will take care about the development. But what the business analyst will do here? The business analyst will be also responsible in the development stage also, where before going to the development, he will sit with the solution team, solution architect team, and he will collect the requirements, what is required for the development. For example, access, for example, input data, for example, test data, for example, licenses, for example, all the infrastructure, other infrastructure parts, whatever we required for the development, solution architect team or the infrastructure team will provide the details, and the business analyst will act as a bridge between the business team, business team and the architectural team, and he will hand over this to the development team. Once the develop, before the development, again, there is a stage called estimations. So how we will do the estimations and all, we will cover in the later session. But estimations is this stage where we will estimate the process, estimate the development efforts or the FTE efforts, where we will calculate, like, for this process, how many weeks we require, how many hours we require, how many weeks we require for the testing, how many weeks we require for the UAT. All these things will be evolved in the estimation. For the estimations also will involved with the business analyst and the solution architect team. Okay. So in the development stage, who is responsible and what are they doing? Developers are doing the development. Business analyst will take the access part, the requirements of the development before the development stage goes. And what business analyst will do in between the development, for example, development already, he got the accesses, he delivered, and developers are been working to the development. The business analyst is the candidate who will sit with the development team, understand the development, how it is going, and if there is any requirement gaps with the developers, so the requirement gaps will be filled by the business analyst to the development team, because he took the requirement, he created the PDD document, he knows the business and he knows the business process well. Wherever the process, wherever the development team need the support of the functional requirement, business analyst will help. That is first thing. And second thing, he will give the status updates of the development to the customer weekly, monthly, according to the process, according to the according to the project, according to the customer. So business analyst will give the project updates or the process updates or the development updates to the customer. And he will be involving in the scrum calls or the daily meetings to the business development along with the development team. So what are being identified, what are being developed for this week or per day, what are the work we are going to do next day, like that. And development is completely based on the PDD document, if you see in my slide also. So the PDD document will have the complete requirement of the process and they will do the development. So that is why PDD document always, always, always should be signed off. Without signing off, don't start any documentation. It's my personal advice and the industry experts' advice. Don't start any development before sign off of the PDD document or the SDD documents. Again, I'm repeating, don't sign off the development before, don't start the development before the sign off of the business teams, PDD and the SDD document. Next, after the development stage, the development has been done successfully as per the estimation, as per the process, as per the business. the development has been done. Next, we have a testing phase. What is testing phase? Testing phase is the phase where we will test the each and every step of the development we made via our robot. We may have the different types of testing, like for example, functional testing, QA testing, and the other metrics or the other testings you've been done for the you will have to do for your processes as per your customer, as per your client accordingly. Okay, so business analyst will be also once the development is done, the developer who is responsible for the process. He will be doing the functional testing, where we will call, where we is calling as self-testing or a functional testing. He will test himself that these are the steps, 100 steps been automated, and how the robot is performing, how the actual result, how the expected result will check. And the business analyst will also be involving in the functional testing, and he will check the result, like what are the actual result as per the business team, what are the expected results as per the business team. And he will compare the document, PDD document, and he will check whether it is working as per the PDD document or not. And then he will finalize or he will analyze, yeah, it is going good. And then they will move for the next testings. Okay. And in the testing phase, business analyst will prepare the test cases as well. Or if you have any testing team involved in your companies, there will some of the companies will have the testing teams separately. They will have separate testing team who will create the test cases, and they will take the functional testing and they will do the each and every step in the PDD document. And in the testing phase, if there is any bugs or if there is any errors identified from the robotics process automation which we have automated, so it should be fixed right away before we are going to the next stage, which is called UAT. Before going to UAT, guys, please take care. Please do the functional testing. Please do the QA testing or whatever the testing we call. Please do the testing thoroughly. Then only you proceed with the next stage. And for the testing phase, a business analyst can take the approvals from internally. And approvals from internally, like with the management or some senior management, that you can organize a short demos with the internal RPA team, the senior management, that these are the things we have developed this week, and these are the things we need to identify, or these are the results we have identified, and these are the bugs. If we don't have any bug, then we will proceed for the UAT. So this is what something about testing. So in the testing, as I am again repeating, business analyst will be involved, but it depends on the company, it depends on the project, it depends on the customer. If you have any testing teams available, then it is something different case. Okay. Next, we have UAT phase, that is called user acceptance test. User acceptance test. So it will be who is the owner of the user acceptance test, and what is UAT? The testing we have done with only our internal team, for a so-called business analyst, so-called developer, so-called architect and management. We have given internal demos. The robot is working very fine. The process is working very fine. We have created our own test cases, and it is also passed. But UAT is the phase where we will do the testing with the help of the business team or the process owner. The process owner will lead the UAT phase. Means the business process owner will take the ownership of the UAT phase, and we will be explaining them how the robot is going to work, or what is the process done, or what is the automations we have done. In this stage, process owner will identify and process will analyze how the bot is working as per their requirement, whether it is doing each step correctly, whether it is having any issues, and he will identify that is there any issue, and then they will report to us that there is an bugs or errors being identified. So once in the UAT phase also, if you face any errors or issues, you should start again the development, or you should do the estimation for the new development, and you need to proceed. Okay. So UAT phase will be doing in the pre-production environment or the test environment where the customers will provide, where the business team will provide. Initially, we have done the testing in the our testing environment provided by the customer, but the UAT phase we will do in the pre-production environment. Pre-production environment means it is the live environment or the live phase where we will run our robots in the customer environment or the customer network. So that is why I always said testing phase is very, very important. And please do take care the sign off for the testing. Please do the QA testing, functional testing, regression testing, whatever testing we call. And please do check and then only move for UAT test. Don't go to the UAT phase until you are finalized or you are happy with your results. Okay. In the UAT phase also, if you are leading to any errors or prepone errors or bugs, a process owner will identify the errors and business analyst will take care bugs identified and lead to the separate development again, and you need to explain to the business development team, and you need to address these queries, and you need to start the fresh development, and you need to do the delivery accordingly. And once the UAT been done, we need to see how we will do the deployment phase and how the project go live been happening. This is something. So deployment is this stage. Our robots are done. Development is done. Testing is done. UAT is also done. Pre-production environment, the bots are working fine. We are happy with, the customer is happy with the UAT phase. And UAT, before going to the deployment also, please take care the sign off of the UAT phase, then only move to the development phase. Please take care the sign off of UAT, then only move to the development phase. Deployment phase. The deployment phase is the phase stage where we have the setups called orchestrators, and we have other techniques in other tools. So in UiPath, we have orchestrators, we have schedulers, we'll prepare a solution for the deployment, and they will deploy the robots in the production environment or the customer environment, whatever we call, and the project will going to live. The project is going to live means our bots are going to live in the production environment. So that is called a deployment phase. So in the deployment phase also, before going to the deployment phase, definitely they will have a requirement of the infrastructure. So again, the solution architect will take care, solution architect will give the complete requirements, the infrastructure will give the requirements, and then business analyst will get the complete access or the complete infrastructure setup before we do the UAT phase. Only the deployment setup they will take care, and they will hand over to the solution architect, and the developers are the owners of the development stage or the bots. So that is why they will take care the deployment stage. They will take care the deployment phase. Okay. So he is the owners of the deployment phase. And once the deployments are being identified, once the deployment has been done, we have delivered our project, or we have the project is being in the live and the bot is working very fine. Or the next stage would be, we will call as a handover phase, where we will hand over our complete robots to the customers. Because as we know, as I'm telling, robotic process automation, once the robots have been developed and deployed, there is no manual interventions required. The robots will work in the production environment. They just need to schedule as per the process, as per the time, as per the customer requirement, it's done. And we have handover. In the handover phase also, there are lots of documents should be documented, and we will deliver to the customer. That is done. And there is one more stage called, after handover, there is one more stage called a maintenance. Usually we will call support, maintenance or support. In the companies, we have a maintenance team or a support team. Once the development has done, once the deployment has done, our robots in the production environment, we need to support the business team for ongoing processes or ongoing robots in the deployment or in the orchestrator setup. Because here, if they're having any issues, if they are having any bugs identified, the maintenance team or the support team need to address this and need to fix the issues on time right away, and they will again refurbish the bots and they will run it. So like this, there is a stage called maintenance and support. So where even the business analyst will be involved, where for example, if there is having an issue in the maintenance phase or a support phase, business analyst will take care of the functional requirement, the what is the issue, and how we'll take with the business team, we'll talk to the business team, we'll talk to the infrastructure team, and he will just I will just observe the things, and he will be responsible to take care and deliver the process as per the time. So this is called a maintenance or a support team we call. And usually companies will have a maintenance team and a support team separate, or if not, the bot owner. The bot owner means the developer who is automated the process, he need to take care of that support or the maintenance system. Once the maintenance is done, there is a one more last and final stage called change request. Change request is one of the other other important phase where we handover also done, bots are running been done in the industry, but done in the production environment. Change request may be occurred in any of these stages, when we are in the requirement, when we are in the testing, when we are in the UAT, or when we are in the deployment, or in the live also. Change request, the term it is self telling, the requirement may be changed, or the requirement may be in the requirement phase, the customer may be not addressed the proper step. For example, there are 100 steps. We have developed 100, testing is done, UAT also done. Okay. But when we are in the testing stage, customer is telling in the 100 step, oh, we missed the 99 step, which is important. Can you do it like this? So at that time, we cannot pause our development, or we cannot pause our testing like that. That then the business analyst is the candidate, sits with the customer, and he will analyze the change. He will check the feasibility of the change, and he will identify the whether this change will affect my business. This change will affect my testing stage. This change will affect my development. He will analyze that, and he should be estimate the time of that change, or he should be estimate the complexity involved in this change, whether we can do this change or not, because it's been already identified in the last but not in the initial stage. So that is why I clearly mentioned in your earlier phase, PDD document phase, you should take care the complete requirement sign off, then this change request will not happen from your end. If you missed any step in the document, the customer will blame you or blame your team that we already discussed this, but you didn't address this in your development. That is why whatever the requirement you understood, you should propagate that. You should keep this in the documentation and sign off the documentation. So business analyst and the technical architect or the solution or architect will be involving in the change request. They will analyze that and they will estimate that, and they will go and so on again, how we need to do the development, how we need to estimate this, and how the complexity of the process like that. Okay, this is something about the change request. BA will play a major role in the change request. He should be able to analyze. He should be able to talk to the customers. He should be able to talk to the business team like that. And as we see, maintenance also done. As we see, there are lots of challenges for every role, every process, every project as well. In the business analyst also, he is having some change challenges as well. When he is in a process analysis or a requirement gathering stage, if he pick the wrong process for automation, it definitely leads to a business failure. And if he is not able to do his own responsibilities, definitely it will have an impact on his business. If he is not doing the documentation properly, definitely it will impact to the business. If he is not, it is good, the doing a lack of communication from the business team, or the customer team or a development team, business analyst should always available to the customers, always available to talk to the customers, and he should be able to do this. So lack of communications also will be play a major role between the RPA projects. And he should be thinking whether it is a good candidate for RPA, whether it is not a good candidate for RPA. He should be identified what are the business benefits we should. He should do the proper ROA. He should do the proper investigation before proceed for any automations. Infrastructure issues. We see a lot of projects. They will not provide you the proper access, or they will not provide you the proper testing data or infrastructure setup. Then it will lead you the project delivery time deadline late, or it will lead the project delivery deadline, or the even the what I say productivity of the project as well. And we can and major challenges we see after the implementation also, maybe the issues in the development, maybe the issues in the testing, any stage we may have the issues, but business analyst should read all the people are flexible enough to work with the customers, are flexible enough to work with the agents accordingly. And challenges also, and we have one more important session with the other speakers, so we will address the challenges briefly over there. Okay, so I mean I think I have done my end, so let me pause for some time. And let me see the things. If we have any quick questions I can address, then I will go ahead. Okay. I hope. Yeah, ROA part or the estimations part. No, session is not done. Just wait for next 10 minutes. You have the spot awards also. You have the interesting topic. So just wait for 10 minutes. Okay. We will do that. I mean, before going to Q&A, let me go to the quiz part then. Then it would be interesting for you. So, most of you are been in the session. And if I mean, if you want to hear more sessions like this, if you want to address the business analyst topics, if you want to learn the business analyst topics, so I do have a separate channel especially for business analyst. So where I educate the things with the business analyst concepts and all, you can browse my name, Nikhilesh Sachdev, and you can look into the videos. If you like the video, please do subscribe, which will create more interest to me or interest to my partners or even my the speakers. We can create a lot more on that. Okay, let me go to the Mentimeter. So quiz session, I'm going to do the quiz session now. So before I go to the quiz session, everybody, I request everybody to go to their browsers and go to mentimeter.com, and I will give you a code. So go to www.menti.com and use the code here, which is published here. I will paste also. It is mentimeter.com. So please join there. We will have fun, and we'll give, I mean, we will identify some persons. Let's take 1 minute. to others to join. Yeah, please, I mean, please take few, the website is available in the chat, okay, somebody, menti.com or mentimeter.com. Yeah, it is, the score is available, I mean, the code is available here, okay. Only, I mean, we are 175 people and I see only 75 are there. Please join, because 175 people are there, but I mean 170, it says some quiz. Yeah, just wait for 2 seconds and enter this number. Enter this number on your screen. After going to Mentimeter, you just need to enter the code, then you can join here along with me. Yeah, go to it. Questions I didn't ask, I will ask you guys. Okay, questions I didn't ask. I am waiting for the audience to join. We have 170 plus people, but here I'm seeing 75 only. I don't want to take more time. Last 10 seconds to join. Last 10 seconds to join the Menti. Okay. The first question is there here. Who will prepare the SDD document as per the industry standard? You need to type, guys. I think you will get a type option. I think you need to type. So who will prepare the SDD document as per the industry standard? The answer will be displayed in 1 second. Yeah, the correct answer is solution architect. Okay, the answer is solution architect. Okay, the solution architect. We will see the result. So leaderboard, if we see the leaderboard, I mean the first person is Jaskrit. Next is Prema, next is Indraja. So Jaskrit is the first winner for this, for this day or the first for this question. We have another question. So Jaskrit, you type your name, full name here. Okay, we will see like a time will be there. It will be for 10 seconds only. So Jaskrit, you need to give the name, okay? And next question, I'm going to the next question. Ready, please be ready. There are two winners today. So next question. So the next question would be entering on your screen. Who is the owner of the UAT face? Who is the owner of the UAT phase? You have 20 seconds to join. I mean, you have 20 seconds to answer this again. Yeah, it's time's up. Very good, very good, very good. Okay, so most of you answered business analyst. So the answer is actually process owner or a business owner. So we will pick who answered correctly. Okay. So we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, so the second winner for this session is like Sonali Raghav, and we have next is Meenakshi. So yeah, okay, next time we'll definitely try to do the multiple questions. Can Sonali Raghav, can you email your details actually? No, not email address. I need your name. Yeah, I think we are done with the today's session, guys. I hope everybody liked this session. So I hope everybody liked this session. So let me stop the recording.